Hey guys, it's Jesse from Bargain Reviews, and I've got another phone review for you guys. I think it's supposed to be a Samsung Galaxy, as it looks. So yeah, we'll open it up and show you what it comes with. Decent box. It's actually really made quite well, but doesn't really matter because I don't think anybody will actually use it. So you've got the phone in good packaging. Here it is here. It's actually got quite a big screen. It's got a little focus up on that. Angry Birds and TV. Wi-Fi TV, I think that's a TV antenna. Oh yeah. Is it movable? Yeah. Not bad. So it does have two cameras. It's got one on the back and one on the front. It has a inbuilt flash. 3.5 millimeter audio jack, that's audio out. The power button's on top. It does have these little icons. I don't think they light up, but they are used. Speaker, and I think that's the microphone there, and the charging cable, which is like most phones these days. This is my Galaxy Ace, so you can kind of see the size difference in the phones. Yeah, so let's get to it. Okay, so in the box you also get the charging cable, the wall adapter, the wall charger with a USB slot, and an adapter for your country. I'm from Australia, so I get an Australian one. A set of 3.5mm headphone jacks with a microphone. Yeah, what else do you got in here? You got two batteries. How's it work? There's some of the details for you. Yep. A free cover case. Just a bit of stuff on it. White one. And a manual, which actually has some instructions about the phone. Okay, so the back just comes off as a little opening there, and you just click it up, I'm guessing. Yep. Just be careful with it. There we go. Just clicks off. Two SIM cards, bottom one, bottom two, I'm pretty sure. Micro SD, and the battery just goes in. The battery does have quite a tight fit to it, so it's not going to fall out on you. The case just goes back on top like that. And let's see how long it takes to start up. So there's the power button there. Okay, the resolution of the screen is decent. It's not as good as the original, of course. Okay, let's go through a few features. So we got the call here. Okay, this does have a resistive screen, so it's kind of it's not very sensitive. You have to kind of push down on it a bit. So this will be better if you have it on in your pocket and you don't want anything to touch, or maybe you, like, if you accidentally bump it all the time, this will probably be a better phone for you, because you have to kind of push it down a bit and there's a bit of a vibration. Call from SIM 1, you just press that. Call from SIM 2, you just press that. You have a phone book, if I can get that focused up. Nope, okay. Music, you got the applications there, which we'll come back to. You have services, a call center, messages, and a camera. It is dual camera, so it has one on the front and one on the back. I'll take a photo. So the camera doesn't look too bad. I can kind of, hard to see. But it's obviously not the best. It does, slide along quite well. We'll go to the applications and see what's in here. There's some music, camera. We do have a flashlight. that turn on, or... There we go. It's quite, it's actually quite bright. So I'll just turn one of the lights off in here. Yep, so the flashlight's not too bad. You do have a calculator. Let's see how this works. Okay, calculator works works well. Do have photos. I think I took one earlier. Oh, I took one just then. There it is there. Let's see if we can kind of... Yeah, you can kind of see it. It doesn't... It's not multi-touch. You can't really zoom in because it's ghost. I'm not sure why. Maybe the resolution's too small. What else do we have on here? Theme picture. Oh, okay, that just changes. That's cool. One click of a application. And it changes. So that's pretty cool. Yeah, okay. It has TV. You have to set it up. I don't have time to set it up, but yeah, the TV does work because I've tried it before. There's fun. Let's see what's in fun. Oh, this is Java games. Not sure what's in these. So yeah, it's got Java, it's got a file browser. Let's see if I can play my music to see how loud it is. What is it in media? Yep, media, open. Audio, open. We'll play the same one as before in my other video. Let's play it. Okay, so the how can I get out of this? One sec. Okay, so the speaker is a lot louder than the other phone I reviewed earlier, the fake iPhone clone. And the sound comes out of this speaker here, which is incredibly loud. And yeah, it's actually decent quality. It does have Bluetooth, has Wi-Fi, so you can surf the net. Ebooks, has a recorder, FM radio, video recorder, Yahoo, Facebook, Twitter, Skype. It does have a, how do we get to this? Okay, not sure what happened there. Oh, there we go. It does have a Fruit Ninja game. I think it's kind of a copy. Or an older version. There you go. Ugh, how do you get these? Yeah, I'm not very good at this. But it's got that on there. It does have Angry Birds. It's very responsive to my finger, which is not bad for a resistive screen and $50-$60. It does have Angry Birds, well, similar. It does have this kind of pervish kind of game. Don't know how you do it, that you blow on it. I don't know. Yeah, some weird crap. flashlight, we've gone over that. Let's turn that off. And yeah, it's overall a decent phone. The lock screen is does have the time and the date, and it's just one where you push it away. And yeah, it's not bad for a $50-$60 phone. It's $60 on a Happy Deal, and there's a link in the description if you want to go check it out. And yeah, it's actually built very well. It feels, it's actually a bit heavier than my Galaxy Ace. Thanks guys, don't forget to subscribe, and you can check out my other videos, and yeah, catch you later.